tonight specifically the closest thing because you have rough supporting.
I don't care who's playing in that game. The fans are going there expecting to win.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, tonight they're going there.
That's what I'm saying. We're expecting to win.
Simmons. Let's be
honest. I'm just saying to heckle him and win.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like
mm-hmm.
no matter what. So you know, they do have Kevin Durant, so that's makes it tough.
Yeah.
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 Even with all our guys. So yeah.
Yeah. Well, I mean, they beat us pretty bad with all of our guys last year, so
yeah.
It's gonna be funny if we give it a better game than we gave it with all of our guys there last year.
We have to give it a better game.
Oh, I mean, yeah. Hey, it's more of an excuse to get dominated tonight than
they
it was
won't
last
get dominated.
Year,
They'll play. I don't see it dominating. I mean, if they start to dominate you, then you're gonna have to hack a bin. I don't know why teams aren't doing that. Man. Like, you have to do it.
Imagine if we come back playing
hack. I mean, teams are gonna do it in the playoffs.
Yep.
But tonight, I don't know why they wouldn't do it.
Like,
I don't know why you wouldn't send him to the line and see what happens. Now, if you send him to the line and he makes 5 out of 6 or he makes 7 out of 8, you'd be like, all right, cool, we let it go. But there's no way he should be getting layups.
Keep fouling him anyway. Play the averages.
Now, I'm not saying we need to, you know, just go and intentionally foul him, but I'm saying from him, his last game, he's getting all these layup uncontested.
Yeah, I think he missed
shots. There's no way he should be getting layups.
Mm-hmm.
At any time during the game.
You're 100% right. He needs to shoot. I'd say.
Now, I'm not saying flagrant foul him, but
no,
I'm saying
hurt him.
Yes, I'm saying take these fouls and make him
put him at the line. Put him at the line.
He's going to have to show me first.
You're right.
All right, we just got to play solid D. Stop following him. He's making his free throws.
I'd like under 8 shot attempts for Simmons tonight and about 15 free throw attempts from him.
He should have more free throw attempts than regular shots.
Yes. Yeah. If he doesn't, then we didn't do it right.
We didn't. If we're trying to win the game.
Yeah. 100%.
We can't complain about him not making free throws and not taking shots because he didn't want to go to the line and then playing the game and don't foul him.
Mm-hmm. Shit, I even say if we're up, do it. It's like running the ball on offense and football.
I'm just
do it.
I don't understand. Like, I'm really not understanding why other teams aren't doing it. But I really, really don't understand why we wouldn't do
it. Yeah.
Like, that's like, yeah, like I said, I'm not saying go foul a guy and he's 50 feet away from the basket and don't have the ball. I'm saying if he has layups.
Yeah.
Depending on how desperate we are, you might want to foul when he's 50 feet away from the basket.
Yeah, I mean, you can do that late in the game, but they probably will take him out by then. But I'm saying, like, the first play.
Yeah.
Whenever he has layups from the beginning of the game. You're going to have to make these, buddy.
Yep. Totally agree.
And the crowd's going to be loud, whatever they're going to do. You're going to have to make these tonight.
Yep.
Yeah. Anyone that does have free throw attempts, props available to them, especially probably more so people in Vegas, Eric, you might want to go play some free throw attempt props on the over for Simmons.
Yeah. Y'all might have to tell me how to do that. But we'll see.
Get that William Hill app up.
Yeah.
because strategy, the big return, as we kind of talked about earlier on the show. So our last topic is game predictions. Ben Simmons will be making his return and he will be playing tonight against our guys. Not the entire crew. So it's really not the return and kind of the reunion game as we hoped. We're not gonna see Embiid versus Simmons. We're not gonna see any of that. Tobias versus Simmons, though.
There you go.
Not bad. Okay, so the spread's currently 7 points. Yesterday, I believe it was 9 points, but I think I think it's gone down a little bit since Tobias is playing. So got 2 points from that. So spread is currently 7 points, 7-point underdog at home against the Brooklyn Nets. How do you guys see this game going?
We're gonna win.
Whoa!
Wow.
You're gonna win.
Really?
Emotional game at home. Brooklyn. Still haven't, not really gelling.
They have issues. Kyrie's name just came up in trade talks.
Play well. Being a struggle from the free throw line. He'll have a hard, tough time. It's hard, man. That'll be a hard game for him to come back. It's emotional. And no matter how, you know, it's only everybody can't have that MJ and Kobe skin. It's going to be a tough game for him. We'll win because no one thinks we will. National television game. Got to step up and win the game.
Eric's getting me excited for this game tonight. I was kind of like holding my breath to watch this game tonight, but Eric's getting me excited for this one. Yeah, all right.
PJ's going to have to work his ass off and try to slow down Durant tonight. That's another thing, too. He's going to have like the game so far of his season against Durant. I'm not as optimistic. I think it'll look really good. I think obviously it'll be better than last time. I think we'll look really good and close. Probably shoot out of our minds at certain points of the game to keep it close, but I think they're going to, you know, one of those games where we have like a 4-point lead with like 3 or 4 minutes left. I think we're going to win and they kind of just steal it at the end, win by like three.
Yeah.
But you know what? That's not a bad way to go about. I mean, like, hey, look, man, we're not supposed to win this game, right? Yeah. I do think the spread's a little shady, though. -7 is pretty low, dude. We're missing $130 million of salary right now. I mean, that's a lot. So,
yeah, my concern for our team isn't this first game. My concern is as we go on.
Yeah. Yeah. I do think for as far as we're on the Simmons conversation, this could have worked out better for him to play us in the current state we're in for his first game back.
I think it's worse.
You think so? Why do you think that?
You expect more from him.
You expect more from him. The expectations are there. Like if everybody was there and we win the game, they're like, man, it's a tough game. Sixers play well, they better. But now they're expected to win.
You think he'd be less nervous with Embiid?
I'm just saying, like they have a 7 and 9 point. They're favored by 7 to 9 points on the road.
They're supposed to win.
They're supposed to win. So now you're supposed to win. You're supposed to perform. And all of a sudden, when those expectations are there, that's when those free throws and all that stuff creep in. We've seen this picture when you were supposed to win. We've seen how that looked.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, is he still there or is he over it? Let's find out.
Man. You're right. You gave me pumped for this game. I'm more pumped than I was an hour ago for it.
Yeah.
Well, let's find out. And we'll probably find out an answer very early in the game.
I think so, too. I think it's very important to come out hard this game. Yeah. Come out hot.
Yeah. You can't get behind early on these teams. Now, that's the one thing. That's what I said. You got to manage the game.
Yep. I think Doc is going to have to. I'll tell you what, man. Doc is going to earn a lot of people's love and respect these next 2 weeks, or people are just going to continue hating him again because
he's coaching the Orlando team that made the playoffs when he was no one thought when they were changed the whole team and got all those free agents. So
that Tobias Harris Clipper team was a very competitive team that year.
I think they compete. I think tonight we pull it out and we find a way. Going forward, once we start playing road games, you start playing other teams and that scouting report changed. I think that's where the struggles
come.
We'll start, wanting the guys to start coming back.
Yeah.
If I were the Nets, I would put Simmons on Tobias, by the way. That would be my matchup for him. Like you wanna get back at them, take out their best player because they can't score otherwise, is what I would tell them.
But I've seen Royce O'Neal guard some of the other opposing teams' force. Like guys like to
buy. I can see, like, you know, it's really depends. So, yeah, I see that. I mean, if they start, who they start, Harris or Curry? Do they start with Kyrie? Do they start two guards?
Yeah.
Yeah, they probably will put him on Tobias.
I think.
And then KD will be on. Because I mean, KD's going to be on PJ.
Yeah. Be taking a nap. Taking a nap. All guard.
Your two guards is going to be whoever the other two guards are. Unless Ben's not going to guard a guard. I mean, the way they play, I mean, he is a forward.
Yeah. I like the Melton on Kyrie matchup. Actually, I kind of like that
matchup, and then you have Shake on whoever else, either O'Neal or Curry, whoever else. Like,
yep, I like that. I think Melton can slow down Kyrie a little bit.
We'll see.